Hi, I'm Aligir Lingappa, Assistant Professor in Physics, Government First Kid College, Siriguppa. Today's my chapter is Optical Fibers. So now I will discuss about the optical fibers, how they can be manufactured, how they can transmit energy from one place to another place. Then what about the structure of the optical fibers and so on. Last class we discussed about the phenomenon of total internal reflection. That means when a ray of light travels from denser medium to rarer medium, the refracted ray which bends towards the interface, that means away from the normal. If the angle of incidence is equal to critical angle, then there is no, that means where the angle of refraction becomes 90 degrees, where the rays of light which are grazing the interface, if the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, then there is no refraction of light. That means the entire incident light which gets reflected back to the denser medium. As such, a phenomenon is known as a total internal reflection. That means when a ray of light travels from denser medium to rarer medium, such that the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, then no refraction of light. That means the entire incident light which gets reflected back to the denser medium. So such a phenomenon is known as total internal reflections. Then the optical fiber, so based on total internal reflection. Here the optical fibers are devices that effectively conduct light along any curved path. They are based on the principle of total internal reflection. Here the optical fibers, they are optical devices based on total internal reflection. They can transmit information in the form of light energy from one place to another place without loss of energy or with the negligible loss of energy. In 1870, John Tyndall, a British physicist, demonstrated that light could be transmitted along a curved path. He used a thin stream of water coming out of a hole in a tank. When a beam of light was directed towards the hole, it followed a downward curving path. So what I said, the concept of optical fiber, so it is a device based on the total internal reflections by which an information in the form of light signals may be transmitted from one place to another place with a negligible loss of energy. Here information means maybe data, maybe voice, or maybe picture. Then what are the different parts of an optical fibers? The optical fiber which consists of mainly three parts. The central part, it is called core. Then a core is surrounded by the another part, so called cladding. Then the whole system, it is surrounded by one more material, so called buffering. Then what is core? It is a thin quartz or a silica of a high refractive index, which is in the order of 1.7. And its thickness is in the order of 10⁻⁴ meter to 10⁻⁶ meter. That means, in terms of, say, the thickness is in the order of micrometer. A core is the very thin part, is made up of quartz or silica of high refractive index. Again, the core is surrounded by a glass material of refractive index 1.5. So that means less than that of the core is known as cladding. Here, core is surrounded by the cladding. That means the glass material of refractive index 1.5 less than that of the refractive index of core, so called 1.7. So this is called cladding. So another part, say buffer. The core cladding system is surrounded by the plastic materials of refractive index less than that of the cladding, which provides the safety and the strength to the optical fiber, is known as buffer. Again, the core and cladding system, that means the whole system, is surrounded by the another material, so called plastic, of refractive index is less than that of the refractive index of cladding. So here the buffer, which provides safety and strength to the optical fiber. When an information in the form of light signal, here information means maybe data or maybe voice or maybe picture, which is in the form of light signal, what we know that the law of conservation of energy, energy neither be created nor be destroyed, but which can be transmitted from one form to another form. Here maybe sound energy is converted into light energy. Now the information is in the form of light signals. It is entering the optical fiber through its one end with a suitable angle. Then the light signal, which undergoes series of total internal reflections, and finally emerging from the other end of the optical fiber, as shown in the, say, next diagram. So now you see the this one. What are the different parts of optical fibers? Say the central part is made up of silica quartz, so its thickness is in the order of 10⁻⁶ meter, so called core. Then further, the core is surrounded by cladding. Again, many layers are there, say coating, and then the strength member, then the outer jacket. All they are again the safety to the optical fibers. Now this is the how the light signals transmitted from one point to another point, or from one end of the optical fiber to the another end of the optical fiber. Let the information, say voice or data or picture, is in the form of light signals, is made to incident on the one end of the optical fiber, then which undergoes refraction. The refracted ray is made to incident on the one of the curved surface, that means inner surface of the core, such that the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, then which undergoes total internal reflection. Again, the reflected light is incident on the opposite side of the core, where the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, such that the incident light which undergoes total interreflection. So similarly, the light signals which undergoes multiple total interreflections and finally emerging at the other end of the optical fiber, so as shown in the diagram, such that the information, say voice data or picture in the form of light signals, can be transmitted from one end to another end without or with a negligible loss of energy. Again, you see here, so again the different parts of the optical fiber: core, cladding, buffer, jacket. So that means usually core may be with a higher refractive index material, carries the signal. Then again core is surrounded by the cladding, maybe glass materials. So again the core cladding is surrounded by the buffer. So then again the whole thing is surrounded by the jacket, which gave the strength and safety to the optical fiber. So the optical fiber are made up of bundles of very thin flexible glass fibers. They are usually coated with a thin film of another type of glass of lower refractive index. The fiber ends are clamped tightly and they are well polished. Such fiber bundles transfer optical information over curved paths, although a curved glass fiber appears a bend light rays, it does not actually do so. Light rays bounce along the inner walls following a zigzag path, say as shown in the diagram. So now you see this. So middle one is core, that means which is green in color. Then the core is surrounded by the another material so called cladding, yellow in color. Then the whole system is surrounded by one more material so called buffer. Here the light which undergoes multiple reflections, what I said earlier, that means the optical fiber which carries the energy in the form of light signals from one end to another end, from one place to other place. The path of a ray of light inside a fiber depends on its angle of incidence and the end face of the fiber. Rays that are incident at large angles of incident are not caught by the fiber, but emerge from the sides. A ray of light incident at a smaller angles of incident enters the fiber and strikes the sides of the fiber at an angle greater than the critical angle. Therefore, it gets reflected. The ray, after a series of such internal reflections, finally emerges from the other end. Here, what about the light entering into the core, which travels from core to cladding, that means a denser medium to a rarer medium, as such that the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle. So that means the system which obeys the conditions for total interreflection, that means the ray of light travels from denser medium to rarer medium, and then the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle. So because of that, the incident light which gets reflected back to the core, that means the same medium which undergoes total internal refractions. If the fiber is bent, its inner surface gets compressed while the outer surface gets stretched. Thus, refractive index of inner part increases and that of the outer part decreases. The path of the ray is then curved such that the curvature of the ray follows that of the fiber. then the path of ray of light is a bent fiber consists of curved segments of lights, so as shown in the above diagram. So for a better performance, the fibers in the bundle must be extremely thin and must have smooth surfaces. The fibers in the bundle must be parallel to one another and must occupy similar positions at both ends of the bundle. Otherwise, the transmitted image gets distorted. The coating of an optical fiber with another transparent material, such as a glass, prevents absorption of light due to scratches, etc. on its surface. So you are given some of the pictures of optical fibers. So the first one that indicates so optical fibers, so how the light signals that can transmit from one place to another place. Then the second diagram, then third one, then the fourth one. So all the diagrams, they are the optical fibers. So that the information in the form of light signals which can be transmitted from one place to another place through optical fibers. So in this class we discussed about what are optical fibers, what are the different parts of optical fibers, then how the information transmitted from one place to another place through optical fibers, and so on. Thank you.